start saying what a relative told me. They said, Ettore, what are you doing? You always, in all your life, did things totally useless. For instance, you measured a neutrino from the sun, you measured the mass of the neutrino, which we don't care at all. Now you are doing something useful. Why? Are you feeling well? What happened to you? So I will say that this comes from a justification from me, why these things. And in fact, I had the big advantage to work in high energy physics and also a little bit in astrophysics. And for that, we had to use quite advanced instrumentation. That really, in some cases, for instance, measurement of radioactivity, probably people working in my activity are those who have reached the lowest radioactivity in the world, because we have to specify to reduce radioactivity and all other way of disturbance of our experiments. So we have excellent instrumentation, and many of us, including myself, thought it was a pity that we could not use it for practical reason. So this was the question of the trace element, minor quantities. We were looking minor quantity of uranium and thorium and on kilograms. So we thought we could measure a very, very tiny presence of arsenic in an object that is in air, say less than a milligram. And in many other cases, we use similar technique. And I will say another thing that also on which we exploited our sensitivity to very low radioactivity, not in the case of Chernobyl, I will say mainly about that, because that was not a negligible one, but it is negligible in our country, for instance, for Fukushima. And then the reason was that this instrumentation we used for a different reason, what my relatives say useless, namely neutrino interaction of the mysterious dark matter that permeates our universe, and then also searching for rare events. To do that, we have very rare events, so we have to suppress any way, any form of background of any type. And this could come mainly from two reasons, from cosmic rays, and to reduce, not cancel, but reduce the effect of cosmic rays, we have to go underground. Near Rome, as you know, we have an excellent instrument that is Laboratori Nazionali del Gran Sasso, which is not the deepest one in the world. The deepest one presently is in Jianping in China, but it is definitely the larger one. And I do most of my activity in this laboratory. And another problem is radioactivity. Here I will say many things that probably you know already, but I think it is worth. Because, for instance, nobody distinguishes between natural radioactivity and environmental radioactivity. Unfortunately, they are no more the same. For instance, cesium-137 generated that nuclear power exists, as I will show. This is not natural, but it exists. It is environmental. And this, I put this one because it's quite nice. It is the first evidence for radioactivity due to Becquerel on your right, and Pierre and Marie Curie at the very beginning, Collège de France. I would like to show you how a spectrum, a gamma spectrum, for instance, appears to people that work like me in this field. Some of you probably already had done that. You have many peaks, and these peaks are indication of what once could have been natural radioactivity. Now it is the real environmental radioactivity. Some of the peaks that you see now did not exist once. I would say something that we're doing. We do both in our laboratory in Milano Bicocca, and this is a laboratory to measure radioactivity for X-ray, alpha, and gamma. As I said, we are interested in low radioactivity, not big radioactivity. Big radioactivity would destroy our results. And then there are other methods, mainly of chemical type, TIMS, plasma source, and especially ICP-MS, namely, which are useful both in physics and in chemistry. What I would like to tell, that was also involved in the Napoleon story, is what we do with neutron activation analysis. You have a nucleus. You have a nucleus, sorry. You have a nucleus, stable, and then you put neutrons on it. We have a lack of neutrons in Italy, as you know, because we have cut nuclear energy, but we have still a few reactors, only one working, and on which we did most of our activity. That is a small Pavia reactor, very old one, but very good, and that has been used in many things, especially in archaeometry, namely to study archaeological objects. And that was a big fortune for us. In this case, you have the neutron that you see here produce another nucleus that is radioactive. And you can see the gamma rays both immediately emitted or later emitted. And the typical example, that was the question of Napoleon too, is that you have arsenic. The arsenic has only one isotope, which is arsenic 75, which is stable. But if you put thermal neutrons, it produces arsenic 76, which is radioactive, has a half-life time, you know, half-life time is the time needed to reduce by a factor of two the activity, of about a day. So if you can measure it, because if it would be too short, it would be impossible. It would be too long, it would be too weak. I have to remind you, which is typical for the probably few Italians, what we study when we are in the high school. That is a question, who killed and if Napoleon was killed. And I use, normally, this poetry written by Manzoni that say, il 5 maggio, the 5th of May, and this is my poor English translation. He say the 5th of May, as you know, was the day that Napoleon died. And this indicate in some way the possibility of a crime, because Manzoni did not know, obviously, but he said that he spent his idle days because he has nothing to do, that it was terrible for him, and he was a target of envy and a deep pit, and people that still loved him, and some that did not hate him. I take this picture of Saint-Hélène. Is a small island. It was located in the middle of between Africa and the state, and it was more important then than it is now for the commerce. This is a picture due to a friend of mine that helped me, that is the director of the biggest museum in Paris, Chevalier is the name, who is really the expert over the world. There are also museums, Napoleonic Museum in Italy. One is in Rome, and I really suggest you to visit because it's beautiful. And another one is in Parma. Napoleon never was in Rome, but the mother was there, and the famous sister. That was not of easy customs, as you probably know. And in Parma, on the contrary, there was the Empress. After Napoleon was put to Saint-Hélène, the Empress, Josephine, not Josephine, the Maria Luisa, was put as a duke of a minor place that it is Parma, and there is a museum there. I would like you to meet these three people that I was involved in this search. One is Napoleon, of course. The other one, a very interesting figure, is the chief of the waiters of Napoleon, Marchand. He was in Saint-Hélène Museum and had a diary, wrote day by day what happened to Napoleon. And he said he was forbidden to publish. But not many years ago, say a few, probably 30 years ago, the heirs of them, since that meant quite a lot of money, published it. So it appears, and it is very interesting, because it's really, he was devout person following Napoleon, and he wrote every day how he was feeling, for instance, which is not negligible from our point of view. Well, there were quite a lot of literature on that, quite a lot of positive and negative measurements. People say that he was killed, others say that he was not killed at all. Reason to kill him existed, at least two. One was that apparently there is a gossip that Count Napoleon killed him because he was the lover of his wife Albide Montholon. That is one gossip. One that is really not a gossip is that was very expensive to keep Napoleon by the British. They have 6,000 soldiers there, many ships going around, because there was a rumor that Napoleon was going to be freed by the Americans. They were in good terms with him. So these were the two possibilities and quite a lot of papers. I would like to show this one because I consider very interesting. This is a negative one. In this one, they took around the tapestry of Longwood. It was the house of Napoleon. As you can imagine, after Napoleon, this become something like the Christian reliquies. Quite a lot of the things disappeared around. And the physicist in England measured this tapestry, where you see the Lilium of France, the Lilium of Paris, that, of course, Napoleon wanted, and found a considerable amount of arsenic in it. That is due to the paint, this type of paint. Napoleon wanted it, but this paint contained certainly arsenic. In fact, I was looking at this, and it was seen that the presence by X-ray fluorescence on this one was about 0.08 gram per square centimeter, a value that now would be forbidden. Many of the things I will tell you now are forbidden. For instance, the question of theirs, we will see in a moment. Now, this means something. This means that was not healthy. Historically, maybe the Italian know that there was an empress, an ambassador, a lady ambassador in Italy after the war, that she felt bad, was living in a beautiful embassy of the United States in Rome, and felt badly when he was in Italy, while when he was in the state. And that was reasonably due to the painting, the old painting of this old embassy, that were poisonous. Incidentally, let me say something before the rest, that now we have remains of important people, kings, prince and so on. We don't remains of people working in the country, of course. Nobody conserved them. Now, this is here. I don't know if you can see. I can hardly see. Since we were able to have some air of Napoleon, this one, they are kept very carefully, as you can see. We were able to have some heirs because we were strongly insisted by the Italian Institute of Nuclear Physics. I was saying to our colleague before that the president told me, you are the best expert in neutron activation analysis in Italy. You should measure the heir of Napoleon. And I said, I have other things to do. He said, when you ask me money for your useless things, neutrino and so on, do I give them to you? Yes, I said, you give me. Then you could do something for me and for INFN. You will show that this was useful for INFN, for the Italian Institute of Nuclear Physics. You will see later. We did that at the Pavia reactor. Pavia reactor is a small reactor. There are other in Italy, but they are closed after the... This is not a power reactor. It's a reactor that is just to neutron activation for science. And we had a very good collaboration with them. Now, we did measurement of arsenic. Of course, air is a small thing. It's less than a milligram. So the system has to be very precise, not because the arsenic is little. The arsenic could be a part per million, but because the amount of material is very small. Now, first thing, what happened now? What happened now that people, we have arsenic, you have arsenic. And so we measured arsenic in contemporary people. Many jokes came out. For instance, one have more arsenic than the children. So since I became something like a detective, I thought that only the wife could have that be done. Who could poison the son and the daughters and not the husband, only the wife, but they was not poisoned. As you can see here, these are part per million and these are 10 to the minus 2 part per million. And you see they are not very different. But at that time was not the same. And in fact, first we measured the people of Aignan. The Aignan is the son of Napoleon. As you know, Aignan means the bird that go away. And Aignan was in Vienna, was kept there in a golden prison. And the wife and the mother, sorry, the mother, Maria Luisa, went every year. And so this is a very, and she brought a chair. Of course, heirs were a member of the son, and he brought them to this museum in Pavia, in Parma. And I was there, and I collected, of all the years, you see, he died at a certain moment, he died in 1826. And you see that it's large, it's always the same, you see, it is around 10, let us say. On the contrary, for Trump's reason, I measured also those of Josephine that I found in Paris, and they are smaller because she was sick and probably she had less contact with the, but as all people at that time had something like 10 parts per million, which is the situation now. Having less, it is compulsory to have less than a part per million. Namely, it is forbidden, as you see, old contemporary people have much less, about 100 or 100 or something like that. So now it is forbidden because it's considered dangerous to have, for your health, to have more than one part per million. And you see, they are all more than that. Now, let us say about Napoleon. As you can imagine, having the heirs of Napoleon was much more difficult. Anyway, we had some help because something we got from the museum in Rome, and are those of Napoleon when he was a boy. And then Napoleon in Elba, because when he was in the Elba Isle, the sister visited him there and of course brought back heirs. And then she was a very easy costume. She gave to a lover of him that was a singer of Bari, and he sold them because at very high price. And then there are those of Saint-Hélène, not only of the 5th of May, but also of the 6th of May, because, as you probably know, the heirs increase also the day after the death. So after one is died, still there for some time, there are still heirs coming out. Air is about, to give you an idea, air is about 1 centimeter per month, approximately. Now, as you see, these are rather right, but something like, to kill somebody, you need something at least 50. So totally out. The fact that he got maybe a little bit more just because it was in that place is possible, but as you see, it's similar to the other. We did something more precise, and what really an adventure. We had a single one. They are very, not nicely looking. They are a strange color, but one was rather long. I think it was about 10 centimeters. We cut it in various periods, and so this means that we measured if he had been poisoned month per month. and they are perfectly equal. Don't worry about the fact that it is twice. It's because during the irradiation, the mass decreases by a factor of 2. And so they are still in agreement, and there is not evidence of any poisoning. Our measurement, of course, then we have to say, because, for instance, the person I show you, this Vider, is a millionaire in Canada. And he decided, after he was retiring, he was very rich, to study there on Napoleon. And he had also 2 heirs from FBI. And FBI say, and is wrong, I'm sorry for saying that to FBI, she is wrong, because I saw the data of FBI, but the FBI say he was poisoned. That is wrong. I'm sorry. I hope FBI make better measurement on other things, but as far as I am concerned, not only me, but all the others, the FBI measurement is wrong. Anyway, let me say other things. We did some crazy thing. For instance, I wrote to Santillin. I never been in Santillin. Our friend, director of the museum in Paris, have been there something like 4 times and gave talks in Milano, full of people with the old rusty guns because they were worried about American comes there. And he liked very much to be in a place where now his grave, England refused to have his body, as you probably know, and he had to be interred in Santillin. But then Maria Victoria did the permission, and now, as you know, the remains of Napoleon are in the Invalides in Paris. The body is there. To say, it's difficult to stop me. I asked all the people of Invalides if I could have a small piece of Napoleon, but I was definitely refused, so I have nothing of Invalides. Now, here we measured the water, because I had contact with the French ambassador in Santillin. Don't tell me why there is a French ambassador in Santillin, because there is nothing there. But anyway, he sent me water and grass. And we measured the water. This is the present. We measured the water, the arsenic in the water, and there is no arsenic. Look, this is not normally true. Even now in the world, there are source of water that has more arsenic than allowed. And these are all below the limit, the present limit. So the conclusion was that, in our opinion, was not killed. But we had an adventure. Namely, this was published in many national papers, but particularly it was published in New York Times, as probably you know, also Washington Post and the other. But the New York Times, as you know, it is certainly the journal that has the larger number of readers in the world, many millions. It is one of the most, probably the most read. And I got contact with the scientific attaché there, very intelligent people, and he wrote a paper on that. And that is a paper on our time with a beautiful beauty, and then now you can see what he said. He said, now a team of scientists at Italy, National Institute of Nuclear Physics, so after all the president got something from me, from Milano Bicocca and Pavia had uncovered strong evidence of the contrary. The president, I think, went, maybe to the president of the council or something, I said, look, you always say that the NFN is doing nothing. Look at these things. They discovered that Napoleon was not killed. Now, we had then letters, and we had contact with many pathologists. And we wrote a common paper, because these pathologists were very good. They did a scientific measurement of the death of Napoleon. The autopsy of Napoleon was written by a famous Anton Marchi, was a great anatomopathologist. The doctors were very poor. When somebody asked me, who killed Napoleon? And they said, the doctors. The doctor definitely gave totally wrong treatment to him. Anyway, this study of on the body of Napoleon are 9 pages, difficult to understand by me. Fortunately, my former wife that I lost, she was a doctor, and with her I understood what is written then, at that time. And we wrote this, he measured, for instance, he went in the 12th museum and measured how big was Napoleon, because there were always the pants of Napoleon, measured all the pants, make distribution, these are distribution of the pants of Napoleon. And in this way, it concluded, and we wrote a common paper. But the name is Alessandro Lulli, who is director of the Department of Anatomopathology of the University of Bern in England, in Switzerland. And we wrote a paper where he say the medical mystery of Napoleon Bonaparte, an interdisciplinary expose, because you see various names of physicists here from Milano Bicocca and Pavia, and the conclusion was common that he was not killed. Now I pass to the second part of my talk that still implies the use of very sophisticated instrumentation. I am not going to talk about nuclear fission, I think everybody knows, and only I remind you that nuclear fission is something that produces an incredible amount of energy, because you know that chemist means a few electron volts. Nuclear physics means million electron volts. So in principle, from nuclear physics, we can have a tremendous amount. And this is the advantage and also the problem. And we saw the problem. Now, what is nuclear fission? I just quote you that you have a chain reaction and you need neutrons to produce them, and you need a moderator to reduce the flux of neutrons. Just because I like it, that is just for my like. This is the first reactor. The first reactor was done by Fermi, Enrico Fermi, in the swimming pool of the University of Boston. And it was forbidden, absolutely forbidden, not only to take pictures, obviously, for military reason, but also to take notes or drawing. However, one, that is this gentleman that you see here, after took a note. And I like to show this because give you an idea, this was the first reactor. Power produced by this reactor was 100 watt, namely a lamp, not big lamp. And you see, they have the various people here. We have, for instance, you have Enrico Fermi, you see, that put the object inside, and on the other side, the moderator, and on the other side there is another fellow who was putting cadmium rod to stop the reaction, because they were very much worried. But that was not enough, because Fermi was very precise and very cautious, and I think we should be like him now, my colleagues. Because it was not enough for him. Because he said, maybe this is not... The fellow here, man who wrote the thing, said that there was no problem of safety, because if he had found that some increase of the reaction, he could have simply taken away the moderator. Well, it was not enough. He wanted one to be here with some cadmium rods that also stopped with a rope and something to cut the rope, because if something terrible had happened, he did not want to do that. And at the end he wrote, I came out, this one, I did nothing all the day, and never I felt so stupid in my life, because nothing happened, fortunately. On the contrary, the reaction happened, as you know, December 2, 1942, you know the famous phrase written to the people in Los Alamos, they say, the Italian navigator reached the world, the new world. He was in, of course. How are the natives? The natives be the neutrons. And he said, peaceful, friendly. because there was not a real explosion. Now, I come back, I skip because I was shown, just to say something very extreme that they say, when we did this measurement, we were here, and the reactor was on and was below. We were on the top of the reactor. And be sure that I don't like to die for radiation. So sometime, if one, this is a small reactor, clearly. I have not sit on that in Chernobyl or in Fukushima, that's obvious. But that was in order to avoid sometime, because people are against also this poor reactor of Pavia, and they want to close it. I would like to say something on the effect of radiation. In fact, this is a part important of my talk. Because, let us say, they use the units. The units are millisievert per year. What we get normally here, for instance, is about 3 millisievert per year. Change considerably. For instance, in St. Peter Square, due to the marble, there are 7 millisievert per year. This does not mean that they are going to arrest the Pope, because it is more than what. In fact, the law says should be no more than 1 millisievert per year. So if we apply the law, we should arrest the Pope. But my interpretation is that there should be no more than 1 millisievert per year above the natural activity. Not activity that you measure. Just to give you an idea, and then maybe if I have a second, I will tell you something of an inquiry that I did myself as a policeman. Namely, the death for radiation, the death measured after 30 days. As you know, the death come much later, but after 30 days, case of Hiroshima and Nagasaki, about 50% of the people die. And the activity should be something like, the activity should be something like 20, between 2.5 and 4.5 sievert, not millisievert. So people here get something like 1,000 times that what would kill them. The dose are not known. Radiotherapy and radiodiagnostic give considerable radioactivity. To give you an idea, advanced country, the radioactivity, the dose given by the radioactivity is about affecting 1 over 20 in Africa. Because under developed country, radiation for therapy and so on is much less, not because they are staying well. These are not a problem. Smokers, if you smoke, smokers collect natural radioactivity from lead 210 and polonium 110. You smoke and get more radioactivity. How much? Smoker gets something like 30% more radioactivity than normal people, which does not mean that this is going to kill you if you smoke, because as I have shown you, change from 1 to 1.7 or millisievert per year. So don't smoke, but for different reasons, not for the radiation. Enrichment, this is important for our consideration, because which is the percentage of uranium, and this is really political, which is the percentage that you need, the percentage in uranium? In natural uranium, the percentage of uranium-135, which is the one that starts the reaction, is about 0.7%. Uranium for power reactors, the one that produces energy, range between 3 and 5%. Small reactor, be careful about that, small reactor are those on submarines. For instance, the Kursk. I think you remember the story of the Kursk, the Russian submarine that sunk in some way. For small, and also the Russian have some satellites on with a small reactor on it, which personally I don't like particularly. And then uranium for make bombs need to be something like 90%. The problem of enriched, I'm sure everybody of you follow it on the newspaper. What does Iran do? Iran has reached the 20%. Now are trying to stop it because they have not 90%. But of course, if you increase, at the moment at the end, you arrive to 90%. So that is really important, this point. If you have some question on that, I could say a little bit more. Now, Chernobyl event. In fact, I talk about Fukushima, but the Chernobyl event was very bad. Just now, a few hours ago, coming by train, I saw on the newspaper that now are worried about animals in Turin and also in Abruzzi that are the cinghiale, that is the wild pox. And they say that these cinghiale are radioactive. First, I thought it was nonsense. It's not a nonsense. These are were poisoned at the time of, or the food they eat was poisoned at the time of Chernobyl, and still exist because it has a half-life time of 30 years. So cesium still exists, and we measure many of them. This is something, well, Chernobyl was a reactor. My student, when I was teaching the Chernobyl accident, I call it Chernobyl accident. And one student of mine told me, look, professor, I disagree with you. Because if one enter in the highway with a car, without brakes, without driving, with anything, and collects another car, this is not an accident, this is a crime. This is correct, my student is correct. Chernobyl was not an accident, it was a crime. I have to say that the person that ordered it, this test, was put in prison, were put on trial, and got something like 10 years of jail. They didn't follow the 10 years of jail because they died before. It's tragic, but that is the situation. You see, this is the top before, a very poor picture, the top before, and you see people, you cannot see where, but there are people working there. The reactor was not operating in that moment. This is the figure of the reactor, and this is the figure of the reactor. I don't think I have to comment it. This is the sarcophagus that was not enough, but it was put on top of it. So this is how the same figure that you have seen before after the explosion. Now, unfortunately, how much time do I have, Catalina? Somebody can tell me how much time I have. Well, then I will be brief. So I am not going because what happened, this I'm sorry I cannot tell you, but what happened is something, a mixture of crazy people, people not expert, and politics. In few words, the reactor was a military reactor, projected as a military reactor, very useful for the production of energy, but the design of a military reactor. This reactor was very, say, economic, but used as moderator not the water that normally is used, but graphite. And it means that the graphite is there. When they wanted to stop, they could not take away. If there be water, water would be left. But the water was simply going to circulate the power. So it was graphite. And the graphite was supposed not to burn, but the temperature reached 2,000 degrees. At that temperature, graphite burned and put quite a lot of incredible things in the air around. There was people, a certain moment, you know, that is almost comic if it don't be tragic. The reason happened for a test of safety. They had to do a test of safety. The test of safety was because, of course, the reactor doesn't receive energy from other place, produce itself. And when you close it, by Bolan system, all the things continues to, for some time, to move and then produce other electricity. So this safety was done to be done on Sunday. Never do something on Sunday, as you can imagine. was done on Sunday. But what is the reason of the safe, the test was the following: to decrease the power of the reactor, and at the level that they could close and have the circulation produced. But when the things had to do starting the day before. But at a certain moment, when it was decreased, but from the standard value before to about 9,000 megawatts, the director of the Communist Party of Kiev found that, what are you doing? You are reducing the power. Stop the reducing. So for a few hours, they stopped it there. That was against the system, because there was a protocol to do that. Everything happened, as you can see from here, starting practically with the 23 of that night. And as you see, happened in few minutes, because they did everything you could do. It was a crime. Everything you could do, for instance, the computer continuously tried to stop all the position, and they stopped the computer. Then there was a system that you have to press the system and to have the cadmium rods to go down. And the system of alarm saying, press the system, press the button. They didn't press the button. And after some time, it imploded. Then they pressed the button, but the thing was too hot down. And so the cadmium rod stopped. And then the rest took, as you can see, these are time after the one, and you see that take few seconds for have the final explosion. And then when you had the Fleischer explosion, while this was done very badly, we have to say that the political system was such that the police could act. So the police immediately, there was an early village around, and this village was about 50 Priapat, it was 50,000 people. And in the afternoon of the Monday, the day after, the police went to all families there to give iodine in order to stop the iodine contamination. Now, suppose happen now in Italy that arrive the police and this, take this iodine. Wait, I have to ask my doctor, I have to ask my... Anyway, they all got that, but that was not enough. The tragedy was a tragedy, but probably could have been worse in some way had not been for that. This is the cesium-137 fallout. You see, from there, you see this most place, then you go down, 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 and then reach not necessarily particularly near to us. For instance, in our case, it was on the top of the Gran Sasso the most. Quite a lot of things arrived in Greece. Politically, reaction was completely different. In France, all parties, including the Communist Party, minimized that. Because as you know, France produced 70% of electric power, even now, nuclear power. In Italy, the law was reasonably good. But the law immediately was forbidding to eat salad or things like that, and salad was full of cesium, not a question. But incredible. I will tell you what happened to me, if you don't mind, because I was the worst days of my life. This is our measurement, the very first look at the date, and I'm still rather happy, because this measurement of radioactivity is not bad. In this moment, the reaction was not yet, this cloud for Chernobyl didn't arrive yet. And that means that you see many peaks, you see them. They are not bad. I showed the one before, but these are not, they are worse, but not that bad. As you can see here, there are typical radioactivity. One typical radioactivity is, it is potassium 40, for instance. Your salt in your kitchen is radioactive, but don't worry about that. And then there are other medium, these are natural radioactivity. Then you go on, I was in Rome, and I remember I came that on the night, and I saw, nothing happened. Then I said, well, let us see tomorrow morning, and then I will show you what I after see. The system is normalized, so when a peak is too high, it decreases. So you see here the potassium peak, but I think I don't have to tell you that the potassium was not less, was the same as before. And all the others are radioactivity due to Chernobyl, especially dangerous iodine and cesium, but especially iodine because it goes in the thyroid. Not all doctors are stupid. In Milan, the doctors who did some scintigraphy and gave iodine 121 to the people die that were to be measured, didn't give it because they said, we have enough with the one of Chernobyl. And so they didn't treat the patient. That was very intelligent. They didn't treat the patient to see the scintigraphy. That is not for therapy or for this diagnosis. Then, a situation, I didn't sleep these days, I have to say. Then, later, came less and less, and at the end of the month of June, the poor potassium seems much, but it is the same as before. And the other also exists, especially cesium, because cesium has 30 years or half lifetime, cesium 137. So that is the situation. Then you see the various decrease of the various nuclei. And as you see, the iodine decreases rapidly, but cesium, as you can see, does not decrease so rapidly. Very quickly, because I want to come, this is the global activity. This is the cesium in Lombardy at that period, in different places. This is measurement indeed on the top of the Gran Sasso. And these are the measurements that were done by a professor of L'Aquila together with my student, my girl student. In fact, he looked to me more interested to my students than to the cesium 137, I have to say. Anyway, he did a good work on that. Now measure it today. You would be surprised to hear today because I'm talking about cesium. Now, this is today. Today, the grass and the mushroom are still radioactive. Problem not for your safety. But people talk about that, and there are many people that are really, for instance, this is a tree, and we measure the radioactivity in the various years of the tree. You have a system to measure, of course, the. This I would like to say, this is a type not eatable. And this is one is the worst. Rosite caperata, I don't know the name in Italian, it is the worst. Still cesium. This is the list of various types of the worst. Is Boletus is not that bad. Cantarellus cibarius, not that bad. But see, look, rosite caperata is not eatable. So no problem, but look at that. You have an idea. And you see, if you take potassium, you can look that it doesn't change too much, apart from the tricholoma for other reasons. Another thing I would like to do, about talking about wine. Bordeaux produces wine. And wine is a very good system, because for the wine, you say, this year, this is the wine of 1985. This is the wine. What happened that people were selling wine of 150 at very terrible price. You know, this old wine cost maybe 200 or 300 or more, maybe sometimes 1,000 euro per bottle. And then there was a study and there was a process and they found out that this wine contained cesium. So it was not possible this wine came from 50, because there was not yet. So people, colleagues of mine, something we did ourselves, we measured the activity of cesium from the year. The year you get from the year that the producer give you of the grain of that year. And you see something that is really considerably important, that this is not Chernobyl. It was the measurement, the explosion they did on surface before. And this is the reason they stopped to do that. There was a famous agreement between Kennedy and Khrushchev, I think, and they stopped it because they realized. But there were not measurements, but this of the wine showed that at that time it was considerable. These are measurements of wine in France, changed from various reasons, and it is very high. I have to say that we measured ourselves Sangiovese from Emilia, and this Sangiovese is much less radioactive than the French wine. Why? This is a part of these things I told you, that one should act as a policeman. Why in France is much more than in Italy? Because we don't have nuclear power, and we don't do test also. An accident, nobody knew about that. Once people found, these are measurements, we found radioactivity, quite a lot, cesium. And then we looked for, then it came out because this cesium came from some cesium used in a Spanish hospital. They burned, don't ask me to comment, they burned this material that was, they were not using anymore for therapy. They burned quite a lot of cesium everywhere, and we found it, as you can see. Now come to something more recent, Fukushima. As you know, here it was not a crime, but probably something should have been done better. Here really I act like a policeman. Namely, first, as you know, the factory who made, I tell the truth. I want to tell the truth. First, the factory is a private factory. It is Telco. The factory who made this system is Telco. And what we know for what happened inside, we know from Telco. We don't know. For Chernobyl, we knew. Not here. Now, there were 6 reactors. 3 of them were operating. Surprisingly enough, the radioactivity came from 2 of operating one, and one was not operating. But the reason is that when the reactor stopped, you put them down in the water. And if there is stop of water or something destroyed or everything, because in that case, the tsunami, as you know, destroyed everything. So even the one that was not supposed to cause the problem, caused the problem. There would be many things, if you have a question, I could answer you. But many things didn't convince me. But anyway, that was a terrible problem. Far from us. Remember how big he was from the distance. Well, I am some way glad that we measured it. Not because I like it to measure, but because this means that we are really measuring at a very light level. And we make some measurement in Milano Bicocca with a very advanced system, but in some way very simple. Namely, on the top of our building, we have air conditioning, the air from the air conditioning that is circulated. And you have millions of cubic meters of particulate that pass. And we collected it in a filter, that in this one, and we measure the radioactivity. In this case, we knew before, because the cloud from Fukushima arrived 14 days after. So we knew about Fukushima, it was not a secret. So we were prepared to do that. And so we did the following. This was the first measurement we did quite before, namely, of course, no more Fukushima. I would like to point, because I'm rather proud of it, that we saw still a little bit of Chernobyl. There was 0.5 microbecquerel per cubic meter from pre-existing from Chernobyl. But then after, it was much worse, of course. These are the various lines, and as you see, the lines are very clear. If you'd be worried, don't be, because for 2 reasons. First, I have to say something in favor once of the Italian system of safety, because they had not apparatus as good as ours, of course. But iodine, that was the most, they could measure in many places, in Milan, in Rome, in Verona, in various places, at least in, you say, in 10 places, they found not cesium, that was too difficult, they found iodine. They found that it is, as you will see, 1,000 times less than borate. However, the fact that we have in Italy, and we have in Europe, definitely, I have data from France, for instance, the fact that we have in Europe system where we see something that is 1,000 times less that were to worry. And the consequence is that this time, probably you are young enough to see that, that in this case of Fukushima, there was not the incredible mess on the print. Nobody worried really for Fukushima correctly because it was so low. And you can see that from this table. This, first, I don't know anything from Telco. What happened inside, I don't know. What I know, there is CEC. People working in energy physics know because CEC is a place, is a laboratory like CERN, to give you an idea. It is a laboratory for high energy physics, wherever they have a good system of measurement similar to ours, and we are in continuous contact. So this is the measurement not in Fukushima, but about 200 kilometers from Fukushima. And you see, these are the values measured in microbecquerel by cubic meter, but these are 10 to the minus 6. You see, this is 10 to the minus 6. What we have in Milano Bicocca, it is, in this case, 3, in this case, 100, in this case, 12. Namely, the activity in Milano Bicocca was something like 100 times less, and here, of course, 100 times in Italy, in Europe, 100 times less than in Fukushima. This means that in us is zero, no physical effect. I would not like to stay in CEC. In CEC was, but lasted only 3 months. In Tokyo people didn't sleep in the houses, slept also because there was the earthquake. So this gives you an idea, and I am going to finish. Other measurement done, also there was a measurement in Seattle. So I'm saying about physicists and detectors and detectives. An ancient crime, we found out that Napoleon, after all, was not killed. Ancient living and crimes, well, we can do something in archaeometry, of which I have no time to talk. For instance, you can find fakes in archaeology objects. Just to give you an idea, as you know, Biak, it is lead, the white is given by lead oxide, and checking with lead oxide, you can see if a painter is of 300 years ago or now. No, if one paint something and use the real Biak, the real white, we can find if it is a fake. If you say it is from 700, it's not true. Another thing is the environmental, this I don't want to know, environmental radioactivity, they are not the same. And then the monitoring and control of radioactive pollution and accident could be something where really, without wanting to do that, we are obliged to do. If I have 1 minute, since this is confidential, but this is confidential, what I have to say is the following, that once on the newspapers, they were saying about a nuclear accident in Japan. Few words, only I noticed because some person, a friend of mine, was going in a city nearby, and he asked me if it could be some danger. So I tried to understand, but there were no news. What I say you, I heard just personally. What happened in this place? And I am myself posing you some question. First thing, what they were doing, that was not a nuclear center or reactor. It was a big institution of nuclear physics. I don't even remember where. They had some uranium enriched to 18% per question. Who give that to them? Because they have no centrifuge. I'm talking about Japan. Who gave this enriched, not certainly Iran, not certainly the other, I don't know. You tell me, I don't know. Second, they are doing something that is simply crazy. Since you cannot use, obviously, for a big reactor, uranium enriched to 18%, because it is too much enriched, they try to reduce the enrichment. That is really nonsense, because to increase the enrichment is tremendously expensive. I never thought that one would decrease it. They were decreasing it. Why? Because they wanted to reduce it. To reduce that, they put water. Water is a moderator, so a real reaction started. And invested the three people who were working on that. Then they stopped everything. They acted normally, because immediately, from the safety point of view, immediately they took out the three. And immediately stopped sending people only a few minutes, because of course depends on the time. So the people entered a minute in this way. And I look at what happened to the three. The three got something like 10 sievert. You remember that I said they're dead. So they had more. All the three should have died. On the contrary, I believe that one survived. When I look at my value is correct. After 30 days, 50% die. But that is without treatment. This is for the people. If you are a people invested, a bomb arrives, you are not treating them. But if you change the cord and it sinks, and they were immediately treated, so instead of dying all the three, only two died and one survived. But the mystery of what happened there, why it was done, who provided Japan with the 80% percentage, I don't know. Sorry, but I had concluded in this way. Thank you.